mom set the bar high, working hard to be loving, to be involved, purposeful parents, but my next guest says being over-involved can have disastrous effects on kids and on moms. Studio 5 contributor and owner of Wasatch Family Therapy, Julie Hanks, joins me to ask a straightforward question. Do your kids define you? This is a problem Julie says moms need to be aware of and act on. So what is the harm and the danger of being over-involved?
Over-involved parents actually can do damage because the child then becomes responsible for your well-being and happiness and sense of self-worth, your moods. So, you know, we think, oh, it's good to be an involved parent. It is, but there is a point where you're too enmeshed. That's to use a psychobabble term. There's not enough separateness. So being a parent can feel all-encompassing, especially those early years. But it's really important for moms to maintain this sense of separate self as well during that process. And that's actually better for kids too.
And explain the impact it has on mom and her well-being and her happiness. I mean, the benefits go both ways.
Yeah, they do. So if mom's doing things that she loves in addition to taking care of her children, then I know I'm happier when I am involved in things that are just for me occasionally.
Yeah.
You know, we think, oh, it's selfish. No, it's not. It's smart. It's really smart.
You're going to take us through 5 questions to assess whether or not your child defines you. And I think this will be so helpful because I'd imagine it's hard to identify your own line, like where you're at. Are you too involved or could you afford to be a little more involved?
Right. And it's on a continuum. So it's not, the answer's not going to be yes or no. But these are questions for moms to just reflect. Okay, do I need to invest a little bit more in myself in this area?
You say the first thing to gauge is how you feel when you're not with your child.
Yeah. Are you comfortable being alone or away from your child? And if that thought or that experience is uncomfortable, there's maybe some work to do there. And so I suggest, in fact, I've given this homework assignment to my clients quite a bit. Do something that you have never done. Do it by yourself. Like, go to a movie by yourself. Go to dinner and sit there. Don't just get takeout. And just enjoy, practice enjoying your own company. See what comes up for you.
Now, what about new moms, Julie, who have a little bit of that separation anxiety? That's normal, right? In the
early years. And it doesn't mean you can't ever be away,
right?
You know, if there's another involved parent or grandparent, even, you know, 15, 20 minutes in those early months can just be enough to go, okay, I'm still a person.
Yeah. This next question is a biggie, and I think it will hit home to a lot of moms listening. Do you base your worth on your children's accomplishments?
Oh, this is so hard.
Big breath.
As a mom of 4, this is a really tricky thing because there's this fine line. It's like you want to celebrate their accomplishments, but you don't want to own it as your own. And I think it's really important to watch our language. You know, so if your child doesn't make the basketball team, is it we didn't make the team?
Uh-oh.
Or, oh, we got an A on a spelling test? It's like my kids will try to draw me in sometimes that way. Like, oh, we have a lot of homework this week. I'm like, really? How do you know how much homework I have? I've already passed the 6th grade with flying colors.
Yeah.
So really letting your child own their responsibilities, their successes, and their failures. And that's the key. When they make failures, if you haven't owned their successes, you don't have to own areas where they're struggling either.
Yeah.
You can just be there to support them through it.
Is how we converse adult to adult, can there be some clues in those conversations that we have?
Yes. I remember in my early parenting years, a friend who I would ask her how she's doing and she would respond, oh, my kids are doing X, Y, and Z, or my baby's not sleeping through the night. And it's almost like she couldn't respond in terms of how she's feeling, what she's thinking, how she's doing. And so it's really important to continue to use I feel, I think, when someone's asking you how you're doing. And of course, as moms, a huge chunk of our time, energy, if not most of it, is invested in caring for those children. And
right.
That's, of course, talk about that. But it's when it goes to the extreme where there's nothing else except for how they're doing, then that's a warning sign.
Well, what about, I have some girlfriends who have been in those early thick stages of motherhood, and they are devoting a good chunk of their day, time, and life to the care of their children. And they themselves actually say and have admitted to me, I don't have a lot to talk about beyond my kids. So what's your advice to that woman who does feel stuck in that conversation?
So there's a difference between talking about what your baby is doing and how you are feeling about the experience. So you don't have to all of a sudden have all these other interests, but being able to respond with what that is like for you instead of, does that?
Yeah, there's a difference.
There's a difference. What you're thinking, how you're feeling, what's working for you, what's not, is different than your child, reporting on your child's experience.
And that leads right into your last question. How does your child's mood affect your own mood? You say those should be two different things.
Yeah, I think there was letting go of interests. There was another question there. So, are we going to the last one?
Sure, wherever,
whatever. So another warning sign is have you let go, or to ask is have you let go of those interests and friendships, adult friendships? And so often we think, oh, you know, my kids' play dates are more important. Adults need play dates too.
Yeah.
You need to have those things. And then the last question is, the mood. If your kid has a bad day, does that mean you have a bad day? If they're upset, a friend has been mean to them, does that ruin your day? And there's some wisdom in kind of letting them have their experience, because then you can support them and you're not taking it on.
Yeah.
I can't tell you how many adults I've seen in my therapy practice who have felt responsible for their parents' emotional well-being from childhood on. That's too big of a burden for kids.
Mm-hmm.
It's way too big. And so taking that responsibility for our own emotions, let the child be responsible for theirs, and not having it entirely dictate. Of course it's going to impact, right?
Right,
when my kids, I feel I'm empathetic,
right.
But empathetic is different than ownership for their emotions.
Great questions, Julie. Great conversation.
Thank you
so much. If viewers want a little help with this issue, they can get a hold of you. How?
Yeah, WasatchFamilyTherapy.com. I have a great team of therapists ready to help.
Fantastic. Julie, thanks as always.